So this is section 1.1, and honestly, statistics is difficult for some people because it involves about equal amounts of English and critical reading as it does mathematics. You are going to have to be careful about the wording of things in a way that you might not have had to be careful before. So that in mind, let's go through and look at the first definition here of what is statistics according to the book. They say it's a science of collecting, organizing, summarizing, and analyzing information to draw conclusions or answer questions. So you'll notice that shares some similarities between my definition. It's a science, first of all, and it's about drawing conclusions, which is basically what I said. It's about making decisions. And so then the book talks a little bit more about this data that we mentioned. What is data? The book calls it something slightly confusing here, but I think this is a little bit better. It describes characteristics of an individual. This could be a number, like your height, or this could be a word, like the color of your shirt. And what's important is that this data varies. They are not the same for everyone. We aren't all the same height. We don't have all the same hair color. We don't wear the same color shirts. And these are pretty simple examples, but they're underlying a really important fact about statistics, is that we are trying to understand this variability. We want to know how things change. Another barrier that a lot of people have to understanding statistics is understanding the vocabulary. I highly recommend maybe making a notebook of definitions. We use a lot of words in here, and some of them you might have heard before, or some of them you might not have heard before. And even the ones that you might have used before, we might use them in a slightly different way. For example, we've got this word individual here, which typically in English you think about that being a person. But in statistics, that's really just a thing we can measure. It could be a car, or a classroom, or it could be a state. In the United States, it's anything that we can measure. So the word individual doesn't necessarily mean a person. Another word that you might not have seen too often is variability. That is a very important word in statistics. And I'm actually going to include a link to a video that gives a really good description of what we're talking about when we talk about variability. So you'll notice the last line here says, "A goal of statistics is to describe and understand sources of variability." And why do we care about that so much? Well, let's think about an example, maybe using Michael Jordan. He was one of the best basketball players that ever played the game. But think about Michael Jordan shooting free throws. Whether he makes them or misses them varies. Sometimes he would make them, sometimes he would miss them. If you just saw Michael Jordan shooting two free throws and he missed them both, and that's all you ever saw, you might say, "Oh, that person's not very good at basketball." But that's actually completely wrong. The variability of his free throw shooting kind of got in the way of the truth of whether or not he was a good basketball player. You have to think about the fact that almost everything in the world varies. And what you see is just a small sample of that variability. So you have to be careful when you want to make decisions about what is actually true or not. Just because Michael Jordan missed a few free throws doesn't mean that he's a bad basketball player. So this slide is quite important because it's talking about the general process of statistics. So, say you wanted to answer a question like, "What color of car is the most popular in the United States?" Well, if you think about what that means, is it's a question involving what we call the population, which is a large group of individuals. And for this question, That population is every car in the United States. That's millions of cars. That's hard to know about. So how do we answer a question like that? Well, what we would do is collect a smaller number of cars, which we call the sample, and from that sample of cars, we would try to talk about what that tells us about which color of cars is the most popular out of all these millions of cars. We use the sample to try to describe what's going on with the population. That is the entire point of statistics. So, descriptive statistics are just describing what is going on with the sample that we took. Sticking with the car example, suppose that we were able to collect information on the color of 50 cars, and suppose 15 of those cars happen to be red. Well, this collection of 50 cars is our sample itself. It's the individuals that we gather data on. And this 15 right here is a number that describes that sample, and we would call that a statistic. That's an important idea. A statistic is a number that describes our sample. In contrast to a statistic is another really important idea for this class, what's known as a parameter. Sticking with the car example, suppose we wanted to know how many red cars are in the entire United States. Well, if you think about that, that's a number. And that's a number that describes the population. It's describing every single car in the United States. So that number is a parameter. So to review some of the vocabulary we just learned with the car example, a car itself would be what's known as an individual. It's what we're collecting data on. And our population is every single car that we're interested in, which would be all the cars in the United States. The sample are the cars that we actually collected data on, which would be those 50 cars. And so the number of red cars in our population, the number of red cars in the United States, is what's known as a parameter. And the 15 red cars in our sample is what's known as a statistic. This is a really important idea that we have a population and we have a sample. Those are groups of individuals, in this case, groups of cars. And we have numbers that describe the population. Those are what's known as parameters. And we have numbers that describe our sample, and those are what are known as statistics. We will use these terms over and over again in this class. Population, sample, parameter, statistic. Parameter goes with population, there's two P's. Statistics go with samples, two S's. Those are really important vocabulary to know what's going on for the rest of the semester. Okay, so wrapping up section 1.1, which really has a lot of important stuff in it, is the idea of what's known as inferential statistics. That is making an inference, a statement about something. So what's going on here? Inferential statistics is saying we can use our sample to talk about the population. For our car example, we had 15 out of 50 cars were red. That meant that 30% of our sample was red. We can make an inference by talking about the population from this sample and say, hey, because 30% of our sample was red, we might think that it might be reasonable to say something like, we estimate that 30% of cars in the United States are red. Is that totally true? Probably not. But it might be close, and that's another important part of statistics, is how reliable our result is. How much can we trust the idea that potentially 30% of cars in the United States are red because 30% of our sample was a red car.